Hey everyone, back again doing another review and install. This time it's my Graflex Replica from the Graflex Shop. This was ordered back in the first week of February of 2017, and it arrived, I think I got this February 7th or 8th of this year. So a full year for this guy to come in. Anybody who was in on this run knows the 2 more weeks joke that kept going around based on the Graflex Shop's Facebook page. That was their response typically for everything for a very long time last year until these things finally started to roll through. But I am pretty impressed though. It is a really nice replica of the Graflex, probably the closest to a vintage for any of the reproductions that are out right now. The color is pretty solid. Most of the accessories are pretty close to vintage. Now when it comes, it only comes in a shell. Okay, so different from the Romans, which his is actually a functioning flash. So you could actually, it comes with all the assembly pieces to hook up to an old Graflex camera and you could use it as a functional flash handle. I think the 89 Sabres is just a shell also. I'm not 100% sure on that. Their Graflexes are just starting to go out now. Obviously, Corbanth just put out the 2.5 version, and he's got some Crystal Reveal 3.0 that's coming out, I think, in the next couple of months. But I know that those 2.5s are rolling out, but those are obviously a little different and not as accurate as these replicas that are out. So, what is so special about this, it's in a New Hope configuration, but the one thing that I did differently in this that I have not seen done yet, in any of the recent videos for these Graflex Shop ones that have come out, is this is dual activation and dual auxiliary. So I have traditionally with these, the flash replicas, what you're seeing is typically red button activation and auxiliary on the slide switch. What I ended up doing is I kept that, and then I was also able to get activation and auxiliary in the clamp. I am a big fan of clamp activation. I know some people like it, some people don't. That's okay. For my Graflex, my Corbanth 2.1 that I had, I was able to do both. I did a dual activation, red button, and then the clamp, and then I just did a single auxiliary here. But with the availability of the slide switch, I was able to get them both in both areas. Now, I was doing this on the replica because I actually had to drill into the lower portion of the upper half. And I really don't think I'm going to do that on my vintage. I do have a vintage right now that I'm working on for an Empire Strikes Back configuration. But I really don't know if I'm going to do that. I wanted to try this on the replica, and I'm glad I did. It came out really well. I'm going to show you guys how I did it. So anyone out there who has one of these right now and is in the midst of building it and wants to try it or is, you know, going to miss that clamp activation, I'm going to show you that you can definitely do it. So when this Graflex comes to you from the Graflex Shop, it basically comes all in pieces. It comes with two sets of bunny ears, as you can see here. These are the 7/8 inch, and it has the nubs on the inside. It also comes with a 1-inch version that's gone, that's not there, which I actually think is pretty cool for anybody that does want those deluxe blade holders that can do a 1-inch blade. It comes with a red button. It comes with your beer tab, slide switch. Comes with the clamp. Does not come with the card. That's separate. Comes with your glass eye, comes with the sync tabs. Now the sync tabs on here are single tabs on either side. It does not go all the way through like a vintage does. So just to keep that in mind, there's just those little slits. Okay. And then the lower half here, as you can see, there's stamping. Now the orientation of this, I actually reached out on the Graflex Attic page a couple days ago just to find out from some of the guys the pommel orientation. I knew about the grips and the D-ring from Roy for Wanawanga's site, and the grips and the D-ring are also from Wanawanga. He's got a nice blueprint up there for anyone who's interested, but I wasn't really sure on how the stamping was supposed to be oriented with the clamp. Obviously, in Empire Strikes Back, there's the Wampa Cave scene, so there's a really clear shot of how that's all set up from a Fulmer. But with this one here, from when I reached out to those guys and all my research that I was looking up, there really is no right or wrong way because there's no clear shot of it. So what I ended up doing is I went on YouTube to SoCal Saber Services, Jordan Eugene, and I was just watching a couple of his Graflex installs, and he had a couple of close-ups of his pommel, and I just kind of took that orientation and did that on mine. I know he's a pretty big stickler with accuracy. I know it's probably a big guess, but I kind of just went with what he did. So, inside here is a Prizm 5.1. It's a blue-green-white Tri-cree, 28mm base speaker, and it's a Goth 3D master chassis. With the master chassis, with all the electronics in here, this thing is solid. This thing's really heavy. I actually like that a lot. It doesn't just feel like a little feather. I like my hilts to be somewhat heavy, you know, one, at least 2-3 pounds, just to give it a nice weight to it. I don't like it if they're too light. I feel like they're very delicate or might break easy. So that's just my thought in my head. Obviously, with these flash replicas, because of how they are connected, because they are two pieces just held together by the clamp. If you're new to the hobby, this is not something you duel with. This is something that you put on a shelf and you show your friends and family when they come over, and it just sits up on a stand, take it down, show it, maybe swing it around in your house a little bit, but that's it. This really isn't meant for any type of dueling whatsoever. The Corbanth version, because that actually, the lower half screws into the upper half, that's the one that if you are going to duel with, that would be the one. So let's take a look here. Also, some of the things that I found that were a little frustrating, well, as you can see here, there are some nicks on the plating for the bunny ears. The bunny ears was probably one of the most frustrating things for me, because when I got them, they were slightly warped. They were slightly bent. So, I mean, if I'm going to show you, these are a pair of vintage ears, and you can see how they're nice and straight going down. These guys were not like that. These guys were bent. I think they're even still slightly bent. If you ask me, I tried to straighten them out as best I could, because it was actually very difficult getting it in, pushing it through this access way here. But once I got it in there, once or twice I had to remove them when I was playing around with the blade holder. And I feel like it did scrape it up a little bit. So it seems like the plating wasn't really done too well on the ears. You can kind of see it's a little nicked in that area also, as it was just basically scraping up. And also the circular housing, as you can see, this is kind of like pinned in and it goes all the way around. This circular housing around the bunny ears, this is warped on mine. I think it might actually just be that it's too long, but look, you can see this here. It opens fine. That's fine there. And there's a screw that holds this part of the lip, and it comes all the way around. And now look at this. Look how far out this is, coming all the way up. To me, I just think that the piece is too long. This probably, to me, should be shortened, and then I'm sure it would be perfect. But when I open it up, I can get it to open, but you can still see that it's slightly off. Other than that, the only other thing that it's a little frustrating, but not a huge concern. The red button, when I push this guy down, if I do it directly over, like if it goes somewhat off to the side and I try to push, it'll get stuck under the lip of the bevel here, and I just have to maneuver and it pops right back up. So I mean, it still functions, but every now and then if I push it on an odd angle, it'll get stuck for a second. That's just a little frustrating, but like I said, overall it's not a huge deal. I just have to be careful on how I push that down. Okay, so used a Solus Holds blade holder in here for a 7/8 blade. I ended up using the vintage bulb assembly that I had from a 2-cell, so still have that little bulb action in there. That kit also came with the Solus Hold. Well, you can order that from the Solus Holds site to retain the bulb release from a vintage to still make it work as a blade plug. I used some stock TCSS, Custom Saber Shops, 7/8 inch stock. I had to sand that quite a bit to get that to fit inside here. That wasn't a smooth transition at all, unfortunately. It was a lot of sanding that was involved to get that to slide in. So, with that, there is, because it's the 5.1, there is sleep mode on this. So, you don't have to have a kill key. I do. I've already taken it out. I use the gold little, or I should say the metallic kill key cap. I liked this better than the hinge that would cover the area. I'll show that when I open up the chassis in a minute. But just to kind of show how everything works from here.
Your father wanted you to have this when you were old enough. Your father's lightsaber. This is the weapon of a Jedi Knight.
This is Wan Sith's Graflex 4 HD. So, you know, traditional activation here. Now we have a little blaster effect. And lock up. And now we should have the same thing also here in the clamp. And then also be able to power down. And then also power up. Nice little shine through. And then same thing here. Okay, so I want to show you the inside here. Now when I do this, I have to hold my clamp. Now the one drawback, I will say, from having the dual activation is that you cannot take the whole chassis out. Goth's 3D chassis is made to be removable, to be able to take out at will if you need to. I can't do that with mine. Now that this is on, it has to stay on. You can take it off, but I'd have to unscrew the lever, take the bars off, take the clamp off, and as you can see in here, here's my switch holder. The switch holder sticks out of the lower portion of the top half as the wires go through. So that can stay, and then I can pull everything off. Now, I'm not gonna do that here because I have the long pins in, which is gonna prevent me from pulling this all the way back. I really don't feel like taking it out, so that part, sorry. I'll take pictures and I'll do it that way. But what has to happen is when you drill in, and you know what, I have a vintage here. Let me take this out and I'll show you. Okay. So, if you realign, picture clamp bubbles, the bubble card going this way right here. Right around this section right here, I drilled a 1/8-inch hole through there. And then using just a nice 30 gauge wire, some heat shrink around the wires, and I put it through. Because the nice part about the way that the Goth chassis lines up is that directly underneath the clamp is the soundboard. So all I have to do is just run those wires through, and I can attach them right on the back side of the soundboard. I have everything else, all my other wires are hidden underneath, so it's nice and clean. The only wires that are attaching on that back side are just the wires from the clamp. So what I can do is if I have to get access to, let's say, something else, I can get access to the SD card, that's not a problem. I don't have to disassemble this. All I have to do is just remove the pins and I can slide this out. There's enough wire in here for me to get access to my SD card, which is right under here, right in here. So I just pull this out just a little bit, about half inch, and I'll be able to get my SD card. If I have to get the whole thing, I would have to desolder the wires and then pull the whole thing out, and then it comes out just like normal. That is the one drawback to doing this. So if you want to do that, just be prepared that you're not going to be taking this out often. You know, the one cool thing is I can still see, obviously, the crystal chamber. So that I'm cool with. Just to kind of go through that. So it's blinking and idle. And it's steady when it's on. So there's two quartz crystals in here, one for one blue, one white, 5mm LED. And then here's the hatch where the recharge port is. I decided not to put the hatch on because I had the kill key with the metallic hat on it. Kind of like that instead. Alright, so let me put a blade in this. And same thing, guys, I'm gonna hold my clamp just a little bit as I turn this to lock it in place. Now I haven't gotten, right now my glass eye is using as retention. I still have the spring in it. I haven't gotten that little piece yet to glue in. I think you can get like a little, it's a little 3D printed, or you can get it, I think, even in metallic, and it will, actually, you can glue that onto the back of this. Just need a little help getting this out. Yeah, this is the one thing, even right now, this is a little stuck getting it out. So, just give me 1 second here to pop this guy out. There we go. And as you can see here, using solo holds parts, but a vintage bulb there. Really nice, nicely and well done by Solo's Hold. This is a 36-inch 7/8 blade from Vader's Vault. I'm gonna gently twist this guy in. Okay. All right, I'm gonna just turn the lights down, guys, so you can see the nice color. This is a nice blue-green mix. This is blue and green at their full strength. Not sure how much the white comes through, but it's pretty nice. If I wanted to do color change, nice mix. There we go. All right, let me get the light. Okay. So, overall, to me, obviously, it was a success. I really like clamp activation, so that's one of the reasons why I really wanted to try this. I asked months ago if it was possible, and guys in the Graflex status page definitely said it was, but there was going to have to be some modifications in order to do it. I really don't think I'm going to do this on my vintage. I think I'm going to keep a traditional, just the red button and the slide switch for activation and auxiliary. But I thought this was fun. You know, I mean, to me, it's a Graflex replica. You know, to me, it's why not try it? So. For those of you that are out there, give it a shot. I think you'll end up liking the results, especially if you are fans of the clamp activation. So overall, really enjoy the hilt. Happy with how this came out. Might tweak a couple little things here and there still, but other than that, I'm pretty happy with the results for now. The only thing I wanted to show everybody was I got a couple of different clamps. Now I have an extra clamp from, this is another TGS clamp, okay, that came in. Now if you wanted to compare that to a Roman's, they're both pretty good when it comes to the stamping. I'm sorry, it's upside down. They both look pretty nice. These are both considered, this is Roman's satin clamp, and this is TGS. I don't think they offer it anything else, so to me this is, They're basically about the same when it comes to that. A couple of differences. The levers, as you can see, are shaped differently. The Roman's is a little bit more rounded. This is a little bit more squared off on the Graflex Shop. The bars, if you look at the sides of the bars, there's slits going horizontal here that really are not present on a TGS. Now, if I show you the vintage, this is a vintage clamp. They have those bars, those horizontal lines going across, just like the Romans does. And then the lever is a little bit also more like Romans. It's a little bit more rounded, not squared. We got these two here. I'll get this one in also. Well, I can't really fit all three. Close. But again, those are such little details. I don't really think that that's a huge deal or a deal breaker. Those are small little things. Stuff that can be corrected even on future runs. But overall, I would say if you really want a nice Graflex, something that's an accurate reproduction and don't want to go and spend a few $100 on a vintage, the Graflex Shop's probably the one that you should be getting. I know, like I said, I haven't really seen anything with the 89 Sabres yet. I know that's just really coming out. I know Roman just put out his second generation. It looks like that one is a step up from the first one. I know the first one had a couple of issues comparing it to a vintage and also with the blade holders. So with the Gen 2, I'm not really sure. There's a couple of reviews out there right now on all of them. So I'm sure if you can, just go on YouTube, take a look, see what the differences are. But you know, for the money that you're spending, the shell that you get from Graflex Shop is pretty good and pretty accurate. So even if you built this as a static, you could do that as well and just leave it. You don't even have to put electronics in it. But this was a lot of fun. I got a vintage coming up, like I said, Empire Strikes Back, but I'm going to be doing the Martin Byers chassis. It's not the all metal, it's a mixture. Some of it's going to be metal, some of it's going to be 3D printed plastic. So I look forward to doing that. And I have Romans V4 that I want to be doing next. That's going to be a NeoPixel. I have an MHS that I just got back from Pete's Powder Coating Emporium. And I can't wait to get that thing installed. That's going to be a lot of fun. But other than that, guys, you know, if you have any questions, like always, leave them down at the bottom. This was fun for me. I hope it was educational for you guys. If you have questions, if you are interested in doing it and you have any questions about how I did it, or if you want some pictures, close-ups, things like that, just give me a shout out. All right? Thanks a lot, guys. Hope you enjoy. Have a great night.